Dave and I filmed the horses in 2017. So there you go. That's something that we first went there on the 8th of February 2017, but we didn't start filming the horse until the 12th of February that year. And we got in free the following week because we missed out on the horses on the 8th because they're already in their stables. So we got in free the following week. And then I didn't, for some reason, I actually do regret it to this day. I never went on camera. I never showed myself on camera until the last day of March, until the end of March. I didn't go on camera. I didn't put my face on camera until the end of March of 2017. And I totally regret not going on camera from the very first day, from day one. I actually do regret not going on camera from day one. I totally regret it not going on camera on day one, from day one. 2017, and I only went on camera for the very first day on the end of March. I totally regret not going on the very first day of February, well, not the very first day, but from the first week of the stud. I regret not going on camera. So I totally regret it now. From the very first day of shooting, February 12th, I regret not going on camera. So to this day, I actually do regret not going on camera from the very first day. So 3 years later, I still regret it. So it was actually the 30th. I think it was the 30th of March, I think it was, where I went on camera. I showed my face. I started introducing the videos on the 30th of March. Yeah. Sorry, there you go. But that's the very first day I showed myself on camera. It was the 30th of March. I don't know why I never showed my face from the very first day. I totally do regret it because I've been filming, I was holding the camera, you see, from the very beginning, from the very start. I was holding the camera, and Liam was in front. Liam was the face. Liam was the face of the camera. He was in front of the camera. He was the face of the camera. He was the face, and I was behind the camera from the start. And so it should be the other way around. I should be the face, and he should be behind the camera. But there you go. But since then I've been the face now, so he's not filming. But he still has to improve a lot now because he's still a bit. He still has a lot of work to do with the improvements, with holding the camera, with the angles. But he's getting a little bit better now. He's getting there. But he still has to do a lot of improvements. There's still lots of improvements that he has to work on. But he's getting there. He's trying to get the angle right. And he does a fair bit of shaking around. He shakes the camera quite a lot. And he's trying to cut my head off quite a lot too. So he has to work on that too. And he's filming. But hopefully now when we go back next week, he'll improve on those points. And he had the camcorder back, by the way. I'm using the camcorder now. We have to. There's no shaky footage anymore. If you got to know, the shaky footage is gone. I've got the camcorder sorted out now, so we don't have to put up any more shaky footage anymore, folks. The shaky footage is gone. You're glad to know. We got our battery sorted out. Thank God for that. So you don't have to put up with the shaky footage for the first month of the season. So when we go back next week, we have nice steady footage. We'll be able to camcorder back now. So it's all sorted out. So come on, wish I could bring me because it's just 3:30 now. Oh, come on! I'll call her because it's in time. It's an anxious time. Thank you.
You have
three. Mom. The race is starting now.
I don't know if I have to take my mother out of the nursing home, if that's
it's safer for her. You know, I'd have to go home and I can't come back to Dublin, so that's going to be very sad for me too. So I'm an awful lot to think about, but I'm very, very safe. But I'll apologize now because I'm not in the best. So, very, very sad. Last night I was a bit better because I was looking forward to coming to the races. But now that it's here, I'm kind of like saying, oh, this is the day of the races now. And it's kind of like it's going on me, you know. I want to kind of look to the next step now as well, so I probably have to get on and off, if that's okay. Like, I want to stay at the best. I don't know if I can go. Also, I have to charge my phone. I'm going to run out of battery.
Did you bet on the Lucid King?
I did.
How much money did you bet on?
€10
€10, yeah.
I just had a winner there. I had a winner in the last race.
Oh. Finished, sorted out.
What's
closing? The laundrette is closing on Wednesday. The laundrette. So we have to hand wash our clothes now. pain in the ass. It's a right pain in the ass. Yeah. So we bought down our last batch of laundry just now. So we have to wash our own clothes now. pain in the ass. Yeah. Nuisance.
Yeah. It's terrible.
It's terrible, yeah.
The thing is, the
next
one's
Christ.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
what. Yeah.
It's very depressing. Yeah, it's very depressing. It's like the world is ending, Anna. The world is ending. Yeah. The world is ending. Completely ending. But at least is one positive. The store's opening next week. Next Monday, so I'm looking forward to that. This is something to focus on. The store's opening next Monday, so at least it's something to focus on. Looking forward to seeing my friends again next Monday.
That'd
be all right. I can see you anyway, at least I can see you.
yeah.
At least I can see you. Give you a wave.
Yeah.
So especially not there physically, but we're kind of there. I can see you and you can see me. He says something.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's your t-shirt? I'm wearing the Paris t-shirt. It's an Eiffel Tower. It's an Eiffel Tower t-shirt. Yeah, lovely. I got it in Paris last December. I went there for my birthday last year. My fiftieth birthday. Last year I was 50, and went there for my 50th birthday to Paris for a few days, and I got this in one of the shops.
Oh yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Went there for a few days. Went there to the Eiffel Tower. It was nothing what I thought it would be like. It's a disaster. It was freezing cold. We're literally blown to smithereens with the wind and everything else. We weren't even properly dressed. We didn't wear proper appropriate jackets or nothing else. We were freezing cold. We're literally blown to smithereens of the wind, like, you know. And we were told that there was restaurants and everything else in the Eiffel Tower. It was nothing of the sort. We were up at the very top, and all there was a hatch. It was only a hatch, there was no restaurant, it was only a hatch, the drinks and so that those certain drinks. It was no restaurant. There was a restaurant outside and it was closed. And there was a shop downstairs on the ground floor and a small little cafe. But there's no restaurants or anything, no fancy restaurants. See, that's the reason I went there. It was my 50th birthday, you see. It was nothing but what I expected. And the hotel itself was a disaster. The room was tiny. I'll talk to you in a while, you can charge your phone. Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
All right, then, look after yourself. Okay, mind yourself. Take care. Bye, bye, bye. It's my friend Anna, folks. So, I'm going to get back into the music for a bit. Do some more dancing for you. Commence with the dancing. Oh, he came forth. Now, folks, go back to where I was.